seen our first guest on Guy's Grocery Games and Cutthroat Kitchen, and today she's here to make some beautiful lemon meringue bars with raspberry jam. Oh my goodness. Please welcome back Ali Tila in the kitchen. Welcome, Ali.
Hello.
We're so excited to have you.
So glad.
Not as excited as Deb, Ken, and Maria, because they've already started diving in. They love it. I gotta say, this is a little bit nostalgic for me. I told you this already. Growing up as a kid, I mean, lemon meringue pie is something that was just, it was a staple in our house. It was something that we made all the time, and I only really know it as a pie, but you've taken that classic with a great twist.
Right, we're gonna step it up a little bit today, and we're gonna make bars out of our lemon meringue pie.
I love it, and maybe just a little bit easier to eat, and a little bit different, and we got a little raspberry jam in there. I'm so excited. Yeah. Okay, the base of this is gonna be a little bit of sponge cake.
Mm-hmm.
Okay,
right.
So take me through that. So we've got a little bit of batter, we've got some egg whites.
So we've made a base. If you've made a souffle, then this is very similar. You're gonna whip your egg whites to about a medium peak, and I don't know if you can see this, but they should stand up, but curl over just a little bit on the top.
Allie, I was working on that earlier. I got it just right, is what you're saying?
It's perfection. Under whipped and or over whipped, and you're not going to get the structure of your cake.
What does it look like when you over whip them?
It looks grainy.
Okay.
And the eggs will start to separate.
So that's how you know. Okay, so if you get to that point, that's too much.
Exactly.
You mix that in.
Exactly.
Now, you mentioned batter. Do we need to know anything special about the batter?
Oh, well, it's almond flour, little cake flour, little butter, some eggs. So very similar to a souffle where you're folding in egg whites into the base.
Is it weird? I kind of feel like I take ownership over the almond flour.
Yeah.
I feel like that's sort of like special
like
to me.
It's like he invented it.
Like Ali's like, I don't even know what you're talking about right now. Okay, good. So we
You can take ownership over any part of this. How's that?
Okay,
because you're here and you're helping me make it.
Beautiful. All right, we got that all mixed in.
Right, and we want to gently fold it because you're going to deflate it.
You're really good at that.
Too rough with it. A little practice here.
I'm telling you. That's pretty impressive
right
there.
You want to keep the air in it.
And something else I want to show you is when you prepare your pan, spray a little kitchen spray underneath the parchment so that it stays in place. How do you like that? How do you like that?
It curls and it rolls and slides.
Exactly.
Man,
so you have better control that way. So
you got it over there. I was going to move it more central for you, but you're okay. Very good. So you pour that into the pan.
Pouring it into the pan.
And then we got to bake it.
Yeah.
How long? Approximately what temperature?
Well, we want 375 for about 10 to 12 minutes.
So it's pretty quick.
Okay, I'll take that for you.
Thank you. You want to get your batter even in the pan.
This sponge cake is delicious.
Thank you.
It's really, I dare I say, the best sponge cake I've ever eaten. I
mean,
I just separated it from the lemon bar because I needed to taste it.
That's
wait till we get to the meringue and everything else.
That's a serious endorsement there.
And it's a true story.
All right.
So it's okay that it's this thin. Like, in other words, this is quite thin, but that's what you want. You
exactly,
want to give you just a subtle little base.
This is a Jacon cake, and it's a fancy word for a light, airy sponge cake.
Okay.
And you make it nice and thin and even, and it's flexible. So think of it as kind of like a jelly roll cake.
Mm. Okay, very good. I'll open this up.
Oh, I love jelly
We're going to put that
rolls.
In.
Or
we're
like
going to let that bake.
Cake. Yeah.
And in reality, once that's all baked and ready to go, we take it out, we let it cool.
Exactly.
Cut it into a square right here.
Right.
You got that?
Beautiful.
So, and then what's on top?
A little raspberry jam.
Raspberry jam.
You want to add a little sumsum to our dessert.
That's right.
A little sumsum in there.
Very good.
All right, so here we have a prepared lemon curd.
Okay.
Okay.
So tell me about that, and I know many people may know exactly what a lemon curd is all about, but I'm not one of them.
Think of lemon curd as like a custard made with lemon juice.
Yummy.
Oh.
Yeah, easy, super easy. Anybody
so instead
can
of what, you use lemon juice, sorry.
Instead of like milk
or
cream, you'd use lemon
Then you
lemon
get your
juice.
Lemon curd, okay,
yeah.
Perfect, thank you.
And again, this one,
it's
you
basically
wanna
just eggs and lemon.
Even it, yeah, exactly.
Easy
and
enough.
Sugar. You wanna even this out just a little bit on the top as well, because you want your bars nice and even when you cut them.
I noticed you got a little wrap around the outsides too.
Yeah.
For easy removal later.
That's gonna help us to, yeah, exactly, to pull it out of the pan.
Okay.
And also, it's very, very silky, where a lot of the curds will be almost like you could cut through them, not this.
Mm-hmm.
It's,
mm-hmm.
How did you do that?
We add a little gelatin.
You got a little gelatin in there.
Nice. A little gelatin's gonna give it some shape and gonna help it to solidify and stay in a bar.
Yeah, it's nice.
Right?
Fantastic. So we're gonna let that refrigerate for a while. And we're gonna cut 2 hours in the fridge.
Right.
That's not bad.
Yeah.
I can wait that long.
Yeah, right?
No problem.
And the great thing about this is that you can cook your bars, shape them, you can fridge them for a couple of days, and then, a couple of days covered in the refrigerator and serve them later. So you can make ahead and then serve whenever you need them. You can freeze them too.
Oh,
I'm very excited.
And just let them come up to temp in the refrigerator.
Are you gonna let him do that?
You're safe because the top is sealed.
It's on.
It's actually a strength of mine, Allie. You're gonna say, I'm gonna watch you go first, and then I'll
right. Follow. Right. So you want the larger opening to the bottom.
Okay.
And we're just gonna.
I've already. You
have an Italian meringue here.
Oh, that's beautiful.
What makes a meringue Italian?
Okay, so there are two different types of meringue in this recipe. The first one's a French meringue, where you whip your egg whites and you just rain in regular sugar.
Okay.
And an Italian. Wow!
I'm waiting for some sort of notice! Come on!
You're hired!
Thank you very much.
You are hired!
Thank you very much. I'm allowed to do that, but I'm not allowed to do the next step.
Which is the torch.
I say, I say that you should.
See that. Okay,
I'll let you go. Dracarys. Every woman should have a torch in the kitchen. Okay. Is that philosophy?
Very good.
Along with the fire extinguisher. You don't mess around on Home and Family.
Let's see.
We're just going to gently toast the top.
Oh, look at that.
So it's really going to show your beautiful piping work.
Okay.
Oh my goodness.
Do you want to do mine too since we're rolling? Do you want me to do it?
Oh, that's so good.
Right. Well, I mean, just press the button.
Okay, good.
I get a little excited, so I got to be a little gentle here.
You got this. You totally got this.
Easy.
Just make sure it's just the tart and not the napkin next to it.
Easy. Oh!
Look at that.
Good, I'll take
you
it.
You guys dig in. That is fantastic.
Yummy,
yummy. You're going to love what you've done.
So this one's for you. And then you can garnish it with a little bit of lemon.
Okay.
Or candied lemon rinds, whatever you prefer.
Okay, so you do a little twist.
Bars are great because you layer and cut it, and they look super chefy when you're done.
He's like a French pastry chef.
Look at him.
Mm-hmm.
How is it?
Mm-mm-mm-mm.
Yep.
Yeah. So good. Oh, I feel like a kid again.
You did a great job, honey.
Brought me back. Thank you so much, Allie.
Thank you so much, Allie. And you all make sure to follow Allie on Instagram @AllieTila and grab this recipe at HallmarkChannel.com. Now stick